Should you feed your Nepenthes? Actually, can a tropical pitcher plant starve to death? In this video, I will explain you everything about how to feed your carnivorous plant. So here we go. One of the questions that come very often from beginners is how to feed my plants and what to feed my plants. So in this video, we will cover these two topics. First, carnivorous plants are just plants. They don't need to get food to stay alive. They just need proper water and light. Never any carnivorous plants starve to death. You don't have to feed them. At the opposite, overfeed a pitcher and he will die. Actually, that's one of the many reasons the Nepenthes could lose all its pitcher, all the pitcher that you overfed. If you didn't have a chance to check this video about why your Nepenthes is letting the pitcher die, you can check this video here. But yes, that's one of the reasons. And now, let's see why the pitcher will die if you overfeed it. The plants consume a lot of energy to produce this pitcher to catch insects and get nutriment. But if the plants have too much food, too much nutriment, the plant no longer need any pitcher. So you want to maybe feed not too much. It's better when you feed properly. The plant will grow stronger, faster, but just not put too much and too often. Quick tip, as some pitchers will tend to die faster if there is food in it, I tend to feed the previous pitcher. I'm waiting for the plants to grow a new pitcher, then I will put food in the old pitcher. That way, if the old pitcher die, it's no big deal, there is a brand new one that is showing off. There is also people that think that if you don't feed your plants for a certain period, the next pitcher will be bigger than the previous one. Meaning if you feed every two pitcher, the plants tend to grow bigger pitcher to maybe catch more insects. But there is no evidence of it, and I would say for sure every pitcher usually is always bigger than the previous one. So it's really hard to have an idea. I don't know what you think about it. If you have tested this, please tell us in the comments. But for me, I never really saw a difference. So I would just continue feeding every old pitcher. Before showing you the next part, the part where I tell you what to put inside the pitcher to feed your plants, I have a favor to ask you. Could you please like this video and consider subscribing, hitting the little bell? That would encourage me a lot to do more and more videos like that, and that will help me also to grow this channel. So if you can help me with that, thank you very much. Okay, first we have to understand these carnivorous plants. Everyone said carnivorous plant, but actually they eat insects, mainly insects. Sometimes you can find reptiles, amphibians or small mammals, but that's more a lucky shot or an accident. They are not hunting for this kind of prey. These traps are designed mainly for insects, but not all. For example, Nepenthes ampullaria grow pitcher without a lid. It's designed to collect all the water, the rainwater, from the tree, and every kind of leaves or small debris will fall into the pitcher. And that's what the plant is eating. And actually, this plant is absolutely not carnivorous, as it allows mosquito larvae to live inside the liquid of the pitcher, because these mosquitoes are able to break down the leaves and help the plants to get this nutriment. So this plant is actually vegan. So that's funny for a carnivorous plant. Another strange example, Nepenthes lowii. This Nepenthes have some sugar under the lid that attracts a rodent. And the small rodent that will eat this sugar will have a surprise. This sugar is a laxative. So that means the rodent will just poop inside the pitcher. And that's where the plants get its nutrients. So basically this plant is eating not meat. What to not feed to your plants? You don't want to put anything coming from an animal there. You don't want meat, you don't want fish, you don't want cheese. Don't provide all this kind of human food for the plant. It will make the pitcher rot or get fungus, as it's really too fat for the plant. And no, Ryan, you cannot give bacon to your carnivorous plant. Okay, now let's talk about what you can give to your plant. There is all the fish food that you can give, from the flakes to the pellets to the dry worms. You can also give any kind of insect. For me, every insect that enter my house will be killed and will be fed to my plants. There are flies, wasps, every kind of insect. Even if you find an old insect dried on your basement, that's still good. You can put them, the plant don't need to have alive insects in it. So it's good. Just put them and the plant will be just happy. The two things that growers feed their plant with are osmocop pellets and the Maxi, or the orchid fertilizer diluted like 10 to 20% maximum. If you have small plants, the Maxi will be the easiest way to feed your plants. You just spread the leaves and the plants will just get the nutrients from the leaves. As soon as the pitcher are bigger, you can start putting Maxi inside the pitcher. Fill the pitcher totally with the Maxi and the plant will just get the nutrients and the water will evaporate after some weeks, so that's good. If you prefer the pellets, if you have small pitcher, I would say get the betta fish pellet. They are really tiny, kind of orange ball that you can put inside small pitcher. That's what I'm using. And as soon as the plant is big enough, the pitcher is big enough, you can use the osmocop pellet. And as the size of the osmocop are not really tiny, you can, if you need, because of the size of the pitcher, you can break it down and just give pieces. But in a small pitcher, you don't want to put a full osmocop pellet. It will overfeed the pitcher and it will die. Question of the day. Do you feed your Nepenthes? And if yes, with what and how often? Okay, that's it for today. So, until next time, happy growing!